As Tony Messenger, St. Louis Post-Dispatch columnist, was there and has been following it all this many times. Tony Messenger, thanks for joining us on a normal Thursday segment here. Dropped the charges in some type of apparent collusion deal, for lack of a better word, a deal between Greitens and her office. She'll drop the felony charges. He'll resign. She won't answer any questions, but we don't know the charges. She dropped the felony charge. Don't you think she should have played this a little differently?
I do. I think I'm of two minds related to it, one related to politics and one related to law. Related to law, this is a really bad deal. It's bad for defendants who aren't white and aren't the governor because they don't have these opportunities. It's bad for the prosecutor's office because item number six in the agreement is basically absolving her office of any wrongdoing. Notice that for all of the things you allegedly did poorly during the prosecution, but in the meantime, the governor isn't admitting anything. And oh, by the way, I don't know this for a fact. I don't know that we'll ever know this, but most Capitol observers yesterday and the day before thought that Kim Gardner's deal had very little to do with the resignation. He was going to resign because of pressure from dark money donors who were about to be outed in the House investigation. So I'm not sure Kim Gardner negotiated very well either. What she did is she protected herself. That's the law part of it. I think that agreement looks bad for the practice of law in St. Louis and in the prosecutor's office and in the state generally, and it reflects poorly on the prosecutor's office, and it surely will the next time a poor black defendant tries to get a deal like that and ends up stuck in the workhouse without access to a public defender and any of that. So that's number one. That's the law side of it. The politics side of it, and I think that's the part that the prosecutor cared about it, she may have won for losing. And what I mean by that is, when it comes time for her election, she's going to say to the governor to resign, here's the piece of paper that says so. And in that sense, from a political standpoint, she may have won for losing. But as it relates to the practice of law, I think that deal is dirty. I think it is awful that part of it's redacted. And I know I'll be filing a Sunshine Law request for it. My assumption is that my colleagues Joel Currier and Robert Patrick already have. And we need to see what's in that full agreement. That is not good practice of law when a prosecuting attorney who's elected and a governor who's elected make a deal to make charges go away and charges that were pretty well documented and were already sent to the prosecutor by the attorney general who said, I found evidence of criminal activity here. And part of that deal is redacted. That completely goes against the Sunshine Law in the state of Missouri, and I hope ultimately we find out what the governor did or did not agree to.
And she's selling the notion that the deal she struck with the governor was such that he's resigning. So she has something on him so egregious that he is going to resign and overturn a duly elected official. But yet the public doesn't have a right to know what it was that was so egregious that he has to resign his office.
When a politician refuses to answer questions, you know they've already lost. I mean, that's the reality. That's what we've seen with Governor Greitens over and over again. It's what we've seen on a county level with County Executive Steve Stinger over and over again. It's what we see with Kim Gardner in this particular instance. She's not ready for prime time. If you've got a deal that made the governor resign, stand up and tell us about it. But she didn't get a deal to make the governor resign. She got a deal that protected her from legal liability. That's what that deal is about, and that's why it's bad law. I hold out that politically in a couple of years, it may actually work out well for her depending on how she sells it. But it's bad law, and it's bad for the cause of justice in the city of St. Louis and the state of Missouri.
All right. Your column yesterday was about this judge in Cole County who is still working on a couple of lawsuits. Where are we, Tony Messenger, with all of these lawsuits. I know the prosecutor in Kansas City who was investigating the picture and the what happened in the basement in his Central West End home. But where are we with the Attorney General Josh Hawley's case? Where are we with the other case in Nicole County? What now legal trouble is the governor still in?
We don't know what the Attorney General's doing, but there's at least an indication that he hasn't told us he's done investigating. Cole County prosecutor, while again also wouldn't answer questions, says he's not charging the governor with anything. But what's going on, and I sat in on a hearing in the judge's chambers yesterday in Cole County, this lawsuit is really fascinating. And here's what I compare it to some degree, to give listeners an understanding. This is like the Michael Avenatti Stormy Daniels lawsuit against Donald Trump. It's a civil lawsuit that opens the president up to deposition and having to give evidence in a way in which the president can't just plead the fifth because he's a criminal defendant. This is the same sort of thing. This is a Sunshine Law lawsuit against the office of governor. And the judge has already made rulings that makes it pretty clear that the very existence of an app in which the governor's office admits this app destroys text messages before any judgment can be made as to whether or not public business was done and destroyed, the judge has already pretty much said, yeah, this stinks. This is a problem. And the governor's office has already said, yeah, we're going to stop using it. But this lawsuit might get to the core of what the House Impeachment Committee was doing and may stop doing, and that's get to a bunch of the documents in the governor's office to find out what they were talking about on Confide. And what happened yesterday was the judge said to the attorneys, get me an order, I will sign it, that gives the attorney who filed the lawsuit, Mark Pedroli, all the names and phone numbers of everybody in the governor's office who was using Confide. And then he wants another order that orders those phones preserved. So we are still in a document preservation phase, whether or not those documents and what's on those phones ever comes out into the public sphere. That's down the road. We don't know. But the judge wants that stuff preserved to see if Sunshine Law was broken. One other interesting thing about that case. The attorney who represents the governor's office, Bob Thompson from Brian Cave, he represents the governor's office. Well, the governor's office has a new boss as of 5 o'clock Friday. It will no longer be Eric Greitens. It will be Mike Parson. Mike Parson might say to the attorney, look, we thought you were representing Eric Greitens. Represent the governor's office. The governor's office believes it's in the cause of justice to open all this stuff up. We may have a really weird situation starting next week where the governor's office is represented by the same attorney or maybe a different attorney. And then the soon-to-be former governor, Eric Greitens, may end up have to enter an appearance himself to try to protect himself from civil liability in this case. That case is fascinating and could get very complicated while some of these other things are dropping to the side.
So you're saying stay tuned. The governor is still could be right in the current governor could be in the thick of it in the next couple of weeks.
Yeah, because Sunshine Law is about documents. It's about opening up the government so that we can hold it accountable. And Judge Beadham has made it clear in the couple of cases he's been involved in related to this governor over the past couple of weeks, he believes in sunshine. He believes in the civil process and the criminal process following itself through. Let the attorney see the evidence and make the argument and see where it goes. I think this case is going to go forward and going to be very interesting in coming weeks and months.
Never a dull moment. Tony Messenger, STLtoday.com, and with us Tuesdays and Thursdays. Tony, thanks for the work this week.
Good to talk.